Alright, time for the December update, which isn't much of an update actually, because nothing was really done except for more printing. I got a little sidetracked with a new guitar I just got, which took up most of my time. And then I wanted to do something fun, not droid related, so I printed this Han Solo blaster. And I kind of wanted it to look like a toy, so I just used colored filament. I'm not going to do any work to it to make it look real, and you know, no real weathering, except I did use some pigments to give the flasher a little bit of a burnt look. So I used brown, black, and gray filament, and then I didn't bother buying brass filament for these three little pieces, so I just painted those. And that was a fun little model. I like how this comes together. So that was that. So mainly I'm doing this video to show some problem, a problem that I found when I printed this bottom piece here. I found that it warped and I wasn't able to catch it in time until the entire thing printed. It took about 3 days. It was oriented towards the back of the printer where the lighting isn't as good, and I didn't notice that. So I think I'm going to go with it and see if I can fix it. It's dry fit right now, but once I glue it together, I'm not sure if I'll glue it from the bottom up so that this aligns a little better, or you know, glue it from this piece down. This is just the brim I gotta get rid of. That'll determine how bad this warp is. So I think what I'm gonna do is once I get it going, I'll try to fill it, and then I'll probably have to come in and recut this panel line to match. So we'll see. Otherwise, I'll just reprint it. It's not a big deal. I mean, that's the cool thing about 3D printing, is when you screw something up or something doesn't come out right, you just reprint it. So then I went and started the other side, and I had an even bigger problem. I had warping on both edges. So I'm redoing this. Plus, I had this little problem here that I think I caused myself by adjusting the belt tension on the X carriage. I did it wrong, not the way Prusa suggests you do it. So I fixed that today. I did some minor maintenance. I lubed all the rods. I did the X and Y belt tension. And I lubed the extruder gears. And then it started coming out even worse than before. This particular piece, everything else, like my first layers and all that for my test prints, came out great, but for some reason this one just didn't want to cooperate. And basically what was happening was I was getting a lot of little air pockets. It would start around the brim, and then the first layer would show these weird scars and bubbles. And I couldn't get it out. I did, you know, my Z calibration. I just was pulling my hair out for hours trying to fix it, changing this, changing that. And as usual, I decided, well, let me try to, you know, lower the print speed. And of course, once I started doing that, it started getting better. So I kept lowering it until it was flat and clean, and you can kind of see how clean the brim is. So the entire first layer was looking like that. So I went down to 70% speed, and then the flow rate I went down to 90, and that's it. I think I turned down the default for this Prusa PETG profile I'm using is 250 for the nozzle, so I just went down 5 degrees, and it's printing really good right now, and I'm hoping that will fix the warping. I won't know till tomorrow if it starts warping, because usually starts when it starts building layers,
And this one, it's Sunday right now, so this is gonna take, this will be ready on Wednesday. If I would have left the speed at full 100%, I'd be done Tuesday morning. But you know, it doesn't matter. I read like these guys are always like, trying to speed everything up, and it's like, it doesn't matter like how fast you get the part, man. It just matters that it looks good. So that's all I care about. You know, I'm not really in a hurry here, especially since I have the dome that I'm working on. So just some advice, if you're having a lot of problems with some of these parts, lower your print speed and see what happens. It seems to, for me at least, it seems to solve 90% of my problems after, you know, 5 hours of trying to figure it out with all kinds of other things that I was doing. Yeah, so we'll see what happens with this piece. If this piece comes out as perfect as 3D printing can be, then I might just reprint the other piece that warped on me so I don't have to do too much work. But we'll see. Like I said, I'm just printing the body right now, but I'm not really going to be working on it until later in the year. So this is the last piece to ring 3. I'm printing, like I said in my other video, I'm starting from the top down, so I'm printing printed ring 4 last month. December or November, I printed ring 4. December, I printed ring 3, and then I'll go from there. And that piece is the last of the big multi-day prints for the body. Everything else, the next two rings are single-day prints, 13 hours. I think the biggest one's like 17 hours. Then I got to print the panel. That's in pieces. It's in 3 pieces and you put it together. The panel door, sorry. And that's it. I finally got these threaded rods for the body. These are 4M 500 millimeter. You need 8 of these. There's 4 on the body, then there's 2 that go on the shoulder of the legs. So you need 4 more of those, so 8 altogether. I got these off of McMaster Car. You could get them on Amazon as well. I prefer McMaster Car for all my hardware. They're just a little bit more expensive than Amazon. I think like, I don't know, 47 to 50 cents more on McMaster Car. But I have a hub that's really close, so I get these like next day. All my hardware comes next day. Whereas Amazon, a lot of times you don't realize it, but you're ordering from China, and you know, sometimes it takes a while to get. Although, you know, I'm not really in a hurry for it, but I'm glad to already get that out of the way. The dome. I did a little bit of work actually yesterday on this panel here. I still need a lot of work to get it clean, like this little guy over here. But once that's done, then I just keep moving on. I found a little seam here, little bubbly seam that's kind of raised. I think the primer shrunk a little bit, which is good, because now I can find these little deformations that I can fix before you start laying down some paint. So I'll be doing this. I'll be getting back to the dome this month. I have a week off for my birthday, so I hope to get some R2 time in. The reason I'm printing the body right now is because I wanted to have something in case I get tired of working on this guy, because, you know, just working on the same thing over and over again gets a little tiring. I can always jump over to the body and do some things there. So that's where I'm at until for January. Well, December, that's all I got done in December. It's January right now. We'll see where we're at in about a month. Hopefully I'll have some more progress to show. Hopefully on that dome. And then we'll go from there. Happy New Year.